Tell me, ma, when I go home, the boys don't leave the girls alone. To pull my hair and stow my comb, that's all right till I go home. She's handsome, she's...
Hello, ma.
How are you, son? Happy Easter to you.
Oh, is it Easter already?
I'm sorry I wasn't able to send you an Easter egg this year, but with the lockdown and all, you know yourself.
I don't like Easter eggs, ma. I tell you that every year. I hadn't heard from you. I thought you might be dead or something.
I know, son. What would I be doing ringing you if I was dead?
Where is he anyway, your murderer, your boyfriend?
He's at home Skyping with his probation officer. That's what he told me anyway.
Do you hear yourself talking at all, Mammy? I mean, your boyfriend is a murderer.
I know. I don't want to argue with you, son. I'm just after getting Easter Mass on the telly.
On the television? Well, that's handy.
I actually recorded the Mass earlier and then I watched it after my Easter breakfast. Do you think that's a sin? To record it, like? Are you allowed to do that?
I'm sure God won't mind one bit, ma.
To be honest, I did watch a film first, one of those Rambo films. Then I put the Mass on after it. I actually fast-forwarded through some of the boring bits. The Mass, now, not the Rambo film. There's no boring bits in the Rambo film.
Listen, ma, there are a few other things we need to talk about besides Mass.
I was sitting on me couch for the whole Mass. I didn't kneel down once. Do you think that's a sin? Me knees were feckin' killing me, sure.
You can sit on the toilet bowl while you get Mass for all I care.
I could never put a television in the toilet. I wouldn't be able to concentrate. I have one of those smart televisions. Do you know the ones I mean?
Yeah. Everyone has them now, ma.
Well, do you think the priest can see me on his television the way I can see him on mine? I had me feckin' nightgown on, for God's sake. And to be honest, I had a cup of tea in the middle of the Mass, and then your sister rang me, and then I had to go to the toilet, then I made a sandwich, so I did miss some of the Mass. Do you think the priest saw all of that?
Would you please forget about the Mass for a minute? I think this lockdown is making you unhinged.
I don't have a clue what that is. Your sister bought me that smart television. I had no idea you could have a stupid television. I think she uses it to spy on me. She always seems to know what I'm up to and how much I've had to drink.
Can we please forget about the telly? It's about bloody time you rang me, ma. I've been trying you all week. I've been worried sick. Now, the last time I talked to you, you had your murdering boyfriend banging on your door.
I do wish you'd stop calling him that. His name is Jimmy Balls.
I know his name. The whole world knows his name. What was he banging on your door for? What did he want?
Well, what do you think he wanted? He just got out of prison after 20 feckin' years.
Oh, that's disgusting, ma.
A home-cooked meal, a little bacon and cabbage. That's what he wanted.
Oh, well, I thought...
I know what you feckin' thought.
So you actually made him dinner?
No, I didn't make him dinner. I haven't had me hair coloured in a month with this shaggin' lockdown. I've terrible badger head.
Badger head? That doesn't sound good.
Me head looks like an old badger snout. I'm not going to let Jimmy see me looking like this. So I told him to feck off till I get me hair done.
So he just left then?
Well, he did ask me for a roll of toilet paper.
He's using you, ma. I hope you didn't give him a roll.
I didn't, me arse. I gave him a 3-week-old copy of the Sunday World and told him to make do with that. Love is all well and good, son, but a roll of soft toilet paper's pure soothing magic. And now that I'm going every day, well, I need all the magic I can get.
Has my sister been down to you?
Of course she has. She brings me the shopping shirt, and then she goes and eats half of it before she leaves. She can barely fit through the door, that one.
And do you have a mask?
Of course I have a mask, and gloves, and boots, and a raincoat, and a plastic feckin' hat. I put them all on the other day, and when I went out for a walk, I looked like your man from Star Wars. What's his name? Dark feckin' virus.
Darth Vader. You know you're not supposed to be outside at your age.
Outside? Ah, come on, will you? It's only Ballyfermot, for feck's sake. Anyway, I'd hardly taken 2 steps when the guard stopped me and sent me feckin' home again. It took me 30 minutes to put all that shite on and another 30 minutes to take it off again.
Well, hopefully you've learned your lesson, ma.
I'm too old to be learning stuff. Now, listen to me. I've something to tell you. And don't go repeating this to your sister. Do you hear me? I've been keeping me eye on Mrs. Mooney's washing line next door. She lives by herself, that one.
Why are you bothered with Mrs. Mooney's washing line? She's an absolutely lovely woman.
Ah, lovely me arse. She's got old men's jocks on her washing line. Big, huge men's jocks. Just hanging there on the washing line, right next to her own worn-out granny knickers. All hanging there for the whole road to see.
That's none of your business, Ma. And how can you see over that fence of hers, anyway?
I stand on the bucket, son. What do you think that bucket is for? She's a feckin' disgrace, that one. I'd love to know who owns those jocks. To be honest, I think they might be Jimmy's.
Jimmy Balls? The murderer?
I'd say they'd be the kind of jocks he'd wear.
Why would Jimmy Balls' jocks be on Mrs. Mooney's washing line?
That's what I want to know. If it wasn't for this feckin' lockdown, I'd be over there pulling those jocks off our washing line myself. Then we'd see who'd come knocking on my door for their jocks.
Mammy, I'm beginning to think this lockdown might be driving you a little mad.
I haven't seen Jimmy Balls in a week.
Well, he's on lockdown too, Ma.
I think Mrs. Mooney has him on lockdown in our feckin' bedroom, and she's taunting me with his jocks on the washing line. She was always jealous, that one. Just ask Mrs. Clark. I'm going into her back garden now, and I'm taking those jocks.
Mammy, this is the lockdown talking. You're going mad. Mad, I tell you.
I'm not going mad. I'm going to put my mask on, and I'm going to Mrs. Mooney's washing line, and I'm taking my Jimmy Ball's jocks from it. See how she likes it when I hang them on my washing line next to my own
Don't
knickers.
Even think of leaving the house, Ma. Do you hear me? It's a lockdown. You're not well, Mammy. Do you hear me?
Feck the lockdown. I'm going to get those jocks.
Mammy, you're not well. Mammy? Mammy? Mammy?